Today we are reminded in a very powerful way of our sacred duty and of our privilege to pray for all the faithful departed, that they will know the fullness of life of God in the kingdom of heaven. We're especially reminded of that sacred duty as we gather in this cemetery and around this altar. At this annual Mass, where Bishop Waters, the third Bishop of Raleigh, whose crozier I am carrying today, and many of our priests are buried, we pray in our particular way for all the departed clergy who so faithfully serve this diocese, as well as for eternal happiness for all religious and lay faithful who have gone before us marked with the sign of faith. Bishop Waters and the priests who are buried here were true missionaries. They came to this part of North Carolina where there were not many Catholics, seeking to bring the Catholic faith to Eastern North Carolina and throughout our state. How proud they would be! How proud they would be to see the growth and the potential of our diocese reflected in the young people gathered here today, representing three of our high schools, St. Thomas More Academy and Cardinal Gibbons and Pope John Paul II. How proud our departed bishops and priests would be to know that in this very exciting and historical moment in the life of our diocese, because of our vibrancy, we are going to build a new cathedral. We are building new churches. We're adding to our parish facilities and school campuses. They could have never imagined how God, in such a miraculous way, would use all those seeds they planted, for which we give thanks and praise. The most recent diocesan priest who died and was buried in a different dwelling place than here, Monsignor James Keeney, was such a holy priest, very humble, very compassionate. And after his funeral mass, one of his former parishioners said to me, "You know, Bishop, Monsignor Keeney did not only carry out well his priestly duties, he carried them out exceptionally well." And then he explained. He said, "Monsignor Keeney did not seek or want or desire any earthly title or reward or recognition. He found his joy in being close to the Lord and serving the church and God's people." Another reality of which we are reminded today, dear friends, in a very powerful way, is one sometimes we do not want to think about. The reality is that all of us will die, and the day and the hour we do not know. And on the day we are called to the Lord, we will be judged mercifully. And we can expect that the Lord will not ask us to give an account of our earthly titles, our earthly rewards, our grades, our net worth. But the Lord, we can expect, will ask these questions. Did you love the Lord your God with all your heart and soul and mind? Did you selflessly and generously serve others? And so at this Mass today, we all pray for the grace so that we may be able to answer those questions in this way. Yes, Lord. And not only well, but exceptionally well. The reality of death, the reality of judgment, final judgment, they do not cause those who believe any fear or despair or anxiety. Because of the promises we heard today in sacred scripture. As the book of wisdom tells us that for the souls of the just, they will be in the hands of God, and grace and mercy will be theirs. As St. Paul assures us that all who die with Christ will live with him forever, because death has no power over us. As Jesus tells us that he has prepared a dwelling place for us, so that where he is, one day we also may be. My brothers and sisters, allow these promises to fill you with joyful hope as we continue our pilgrimage of faith here on earth, striving each day to do our very best in an exceptional way to love God and to serve our neighbor. In this way, with God's grace, we will live with the Lord both now and forever. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May their souls and all the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen.